Sairam, dear children, wish you a very good morning and I hope you all are well. Dear children, today we are going to start Delhi during the medieval period. That is, Delhi after the invasion of Afghan rulers or Delhi after the invasion of Shahabuddin Ghori. Okay, so just before we start the chapter, let's do our prayer. Join your hands and close your eyes and chant Om 3 times. Om. Om. Sign up. So to the children, today we are going to start slave dynasty, and as we studied in the 6th chapter, that slave dynasty is established by Qutbuddin Aibak after the death of Shahabuddin Muhammad Ghori. His chief commander Qutbuddin Aibak established and the most loyal slave of Shahabuddin Ghori established the slave dynasty over the throne of Delhi. And though he faced many difficulties in establishing his powers, but he managed to do well administration in Delhi, and he started construction of a minar due to in honor of his name. The minar was given the name of Qutub Minar, and it was started by Qutbuddin Aibak, but it was finished or completed by Iltutmish. Okay, so Iltutmish was his successor and his son-in-law. Iltutmish was also a slave in the beginning, and he conquered many territory in India and made them a part of Delhi Sultanate. And Iltutmish was also a slave, and he won many territories in India and add them with the Delhi Sultanate. About slave word, I want to tell you one thing, that the rulers of slave dynasty never used Badshah before their name, and they were owned by their owners. Like Qutbuddin Aibak was the slave of Shahabuddin Ghori, he owned them. And in slave dynasties, those people who are slaves, jinhe kharida jata tha, okay, and then those are loyal, those slaves are more loyal than their own child. Okay, so in slave dynasty, loyalty and faith to the owner is too much. Okay, Iltutmish conquered many territory and expanded Delhi Sultanate. So he was the real founder of the slave dynasty, and his daughter Rajia Sultana ascended the throne after his death. The successor of Iltutmish was not his son, because they are not capable to be the king of Delhi. So Rajia Sultana ascended the throne of Delhi. And Rajia was the first female ruler to rule over Delhi and the first Sultana. Okay, Rajia was an efficient ruler. She used to dress as a male, and when she was in court, according to historian of that time, Minhaj-e-Siraj, Rajia was more capable and efficient ruler than her brothers. The contemporary writer or the historian Minhaj-e-Siraj has written in his books that Rajia wears male dresses, and in her court she is more capable and efficient ruler than her brothers. However, being a woman, she was not accepted as a ruler, and many of his ministers was conspiring against her. Okay, Amir Umrao's disliked Rajia as a ruler, and Amirs and Umrao's were the people in the Rajia Sultana's court, and who don't like a female as a person to rule them. And there was complete disorder in the Sultanate for 6 years after her death. And after 6 years of her death, there is totally disorder, and at last the Amir sent throne Nasiruddin, the son of Iltutmish, and he ruled for 21 years. And then the Amirs present in that court, Amirs were the post and the people in their court, okay. So they made Nasiruddin, the son of Iltutmish, as a ruler, and he ruled for 21 years. After his death, Ghiyasuddin Balban ascended the throne of Delhi. Ghiyasuddin Balban was his commander in chief. Okay, he was a strong ruler who brought an end to the disorder and established peace. And he was a strong ruler and established peace in the Delhi Sultanate. Balban had been the wazir of Nasiruddin for 20 years. He was a minister of Nasiruddin, and wazir means minister, chief minister. Subsequently, he ruled for 22 years, and he ascended for weeks. And Khilji's dynasty established its rule over Delhi. Because of the weak successors of Sultan Balban, Khilji dynasty was established and ruled over Delhi. Things to know. Razia Sultana inscribed on stones and coins that she was Iltutmish daughter, and she inscribed on stones about Iltutmish and her relationship. And the Kakatiya dynasty ruled over the Warangal in present Andhra Pradesh, and the attitude of the Queen Rudrama Devi, a ruler of this dynasty, was exactly the opposite to that of Razia Sultana. And in south, at the same time, contemporary to the Sultanate, Kakatiya dynasty was there, and it was ruled by the Queen Rudrama Devi, 1259 to 1289, and her behavior was exactly opposite to the Razia Sultana. In her inscription means the dynasty's rule was directly opposite, as Rudrama Devi was accepted by the whole kingdom. Okay, and in her inscription she engraved her name like a man. And she changed her name. Rudrama Devi changed her name, and she is popular as Rudradev in the Warangal dynasty. Similarly, there was a Queen Dida who once ruled over Kashmir, and she was affectionately called Didi by her subjects. And Dida was the person, was a lady who ruled Kashmir, and her affectionately called, and people by love call her Didi. Okay. Within Khilji dynasty, within the 4 years of the Balban's death, the Khilji dynasty established its rule over Delhi. After the death of Balban, Khilji dynasty established his rule over Delhi. Okay, the Turk community who belonged to Khilji in Afghanistan was known as Khiljis, and the Turk community of Afghanistan who belongs to the Khilji place were known as Khiljis, because they from Khilji place in Afghanistan. That's why those people are known as Khiljis. Jalaluddin Khilji brought an end to the slave dynasty, and Jalaluddin Khilji was a person who ended slave dynasty's rule and established Khilji dynasty in 1296. And Alauddin, who was both his nephew and son-in-law, overthrown Jalaluddin and became the ruler of Delhi. Alauddin Khilji was the ruler who killed Jalaluddin Khilji. Okay, who killed Jalaluddin Khilji, and he was his son-in-law and nephew too. Okay, so he became the ruler of Delhi. He was very ambitious. He controlled the interference of ulemas and umraus in the state administration, and in his rule, the ulemas and umraus power is in control, and they are not given too much or unlimited power to interfere in the administrative matters. Alauddin Khilji framed strict law to control prices, and to control prices in market, he made strict laws. And the famous poet Amir Khusro, whose work are well known and adored in his court. And Amir Khusro get patronage in the Alauddin Khilji's court. Okay, so he was a member or a poet of Alauddin Khilji's court. There was a complete disorder in the kingdom after his death, and Tughlaq dynasty established its power, replacing the Khilji dynasty. After the death of Alauddin Khilji, the Khilji dynasty became weak, and Tughlaq dynasty was established there. Okay. So the Tughlaq dynasty, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, was founded the Tughlaq dynasty within the 4 years after the death of Alauddin Khilji. After death of Alauddin Khilji, Khilji dynasty was totally overthrown from Delhi by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, and Dak Chowki, the postal services was started in his time. And for the first time, postal services had started in the Tughlaq dynasty's time, and the letters were carried out by the horse riders, and horse riders carried the letters, and the postmen were referred to as Halkaro, and postmen at that time known as Halkaro. Referred to Saurashtra ni Rasdar to know more about Halkaro. Okay, Saurashtra ni Rasdar is a magazine or a book in which information about these Halkaros were written. Muhammad Tughlaq became the Sultan after Ghiyasuddin. And Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq's successor was his son Muhammad Tughlaq. Many of the decisions that he took were criticized, and his decisions were mostly criticized. The two main plans were transferred to capital from Delhi to Daulatabad, and after introducing the use of copper currency, the Tughlaq dynasty's economic condition was ruined totally, because he started the copper currency and people started minting the copper coins at their home, and the value of currency became zero. And when he was transferring the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad, he lost many of his soldiers, he wasted a lot of money, and due to which the Tughlaq dynasty became weak. During the Muhammad Tughlaq's reign, Ibn Battuta, an African traveler, and Tangier belonging to the Habsi tribe visited India. Tenzing and Ibn Battuta from Africa visited India at the time of Muhammad Tughlaq. Criticizing the Sultan's administration, he has written that Muhammad Shah's rule was an amalgamation of both good and bad administration policies. Means his rule was a mixture. Amalgamation means mixture of good and bad policies. The Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar. Now we are going to study about the medieval period and the rulers in the south. So in south, the Hindu ruler or the Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar we have to study. During the Sultanate period, there were attempts to establish authority over south India. Alauddin Khilji was the first ruler to launch an attack. He carried away enormous wealth from the Devgiri. He carried a lot of wealth and looted there and won many areas of south. Okay, subsequently Malik Kafur destroyed the kingdom of Warangal, and Malik Kafur, who was a slave of Alauddin Khilji, destroyed the kingdom of Warangal. And the condition of South India worsened during the time of Muhammad Tughlaq. And at the time of Muhammad Tughlaq, the condition of South India is bad. And simultaneously, the Hindu Empire of Vijayanagar and Bahmani Sultanate were also established in South India. And Bahmani Empire and Vijayanagar Empire was established in South India. After the defeat of the ruler of Warangal, the two brothers of Jadav clan, Harihar and Bukka, established the Vijayanagar Kingdom. The Harihar and Bukka was the person who established Vijayanagar Kingdom and are from Jadav clan, Jadav Vansh the wo, under the inspiration of Swami Vidyaranya. And Swami Vidyaranya inspired them, and who was their political mentor. And the Vijayanagar Kingdom was established in the south of the Tungabhadra River, and in the south of Tungabhadra River, Vijayanagar Kingdom was there. And within a short period of 8 years, the kingdom expanded from the Tungabhadra to Kanyakumari. And within 8 years, they expanded their kingdom from Tungabhadra River to the Kanyakumari. And Bukka ascended the throne after the death of Harihar, and is ascended being weak, and a new dynasty came to be known, came to power. And after death of Harihar, his brother Bukka ascended the throne, and after him, the descendants were weak, so new dynasty came in power, and Krishnadev Rai was a powerful ruler of this dynasty. And Krishnadev Rai's rules flourished in the South India, and after Bukka, a person, Krishnadev Rai, was established a new dynasty, and who was a strong ruler, has flourished the South India, and South India's condition is very good at the time of Krishnadev Rai's rules. And he had good relation with the Europeans and was a lover of art and literature, and his relation with the foreign countries of Europe were good, and he was lover of art and literature. He loved art and literature, means he promote art and literature. He constructed canals in the South India with the help of an engineer called Yomke, and with the help of Yomke named engineer, he created many canals in the rivers of by the rivers of South India, so that irrigation facility will be proper there. And foreign travelers who visited Vijayanagar had appreciated its grandeur, and those foreign travelers who visited the Krishna Deva Rai, they saluted his culture and sculpture, architecture made by Krishna Deva Rai. And there were grand temples and forts in the kingdom, and the glorious state was destroyed in the Battle of Talikota. And this glorious state was destroyed in the Battle of Talikot. And the Bahmani Sultanate, the Amirs in the Deccan rebelled, okay, against their king, and Hassan, one of the efficient Amir, became the Sultan. And Hassan, named person who was also Amir, became the Sultan and founded Bahmani Sultanate. And their Mahmud Gawan was a capable minister and efficient administrator of Bahmani Sultanate. And Mahmud Gawan was a minister of Hassan and efficient administrator of Bahmani Sultanate, and he won many territory and extended the boundaries of Bahmani Kingdom. And he extended Bahmani Kingdom, and the powers of Bahmani Sultanate weakened after his death. And after the death of Mahmud Gawan, it became weak, and there were frequent conflicts between the Vijayanagar and Bahmani Kingdom, and there is frequent fights between those two kingdoms. After the downfall of Bahmani Sultanate, many provinces became independent, and among five provinces of Bijapur, Ahmedabad, Golconda, Berar and Bidar became the independent kingdom. These five kingdoms comes out from the Bahmani Sultanate. And with this, the end of Delhi Sultanate we are going to study. Firoz Shah Tughlaq ascended the throne after Muhammad Tughlaq. Firoz Shah Tughlaq was the cousin of Muhammad Tughlaq, and however, from that time onward, the Delhi Sultanate became to weaken. And when he ascended throne, the Delhi Sultanate is already weak, and the reign of Tughlaq dynasty also witnessed the invasion and plunder of Delhi by Timur. Timur invaded Delhi at the time of Firoz Shah Tughlaq, and the governor of Lahore, Khizr Khan, took advantage of the chaos and established the Sayyid dynasty. Khizr Khan was governor of Lahore, and he took the advantage of the condition when Timur was invading Delhi and the Sultan was busy in the fight with Timur. At that time, he established Sayyid dynasty in Delhi, and the authority of these Sultan was limited to the region around Delhi, and their area is limited to Delhi only. And 1451, an Afghan leader, Sardar Behlol, established the rule of Delhi Lodi dynasty in Delhi, and after him Behlol, the Sardar of Afghan leader, established Lodi dynasty. So the who was the founder of Lodi dynasty? Behlol Lodi. And his son Sikandar ascended the throne after his death, and though Sikandar had good qualities of a good ruler, and he was a good ruler and lacked religious tolerance, due to which struggle began after his death, and Ibrahim Lodi defeated his elder brother and became the ruler of Delhi. He was Sikandar Lodi was good quality of ruler, but religious tolerance is not good in him, and after his death there is many problem in kingdom for the seat of ruler. So Ibrahim Lodi defeated his younger elder brother and then ruled over Delhi, and the Amirs were not happy with the rule of Ibrahim Lodi and his arrogant behavior, and so they started rebellion in the kingdom. And Babur, the emperor of Kabul, invaded Delhi. At the time, he defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the Battle of Panipat. And at the same time, Babur from Afghan Kabul came India and invaded Delhi. And with this, in the Battle of Panipat, Ibrahim Lodi lost the battle, and Mughal Empire was lasted for approximately 200 years. In 1526, Mughal Empire was established in Delhi, and for it lasted for 200 years successfully in Delhi. So our chapter is completed. Question answer I will send you, and our this book of first semester is completed, so revise it very well, and from this 26 your FE2 exam is there. So do well and prepare for your examination, and all the best, and perform very good in your exams and get good marks. All the best, children.